Hi guys, and welcome back to the Automotive Diagnosis YouTube channel. Today I had a car with airbag light on, which was from the driver airbag. After changing the airbag, I decided to deploy it as recommended by the manufacturer. But this time, I secured the airbag in the vise with some zip ties to record the video for you. But after airbag deployment, my friends asked some questions about the discharged gas after the deployment, if it is toxic or not. So after watching the airbag deployment, I will talk about that gas and will give you all details and information you need. Let's see the airbag deployment first. As you see, for the safety reason, I ensured that airbag is secured and it won't move after the explosion. I also used two long wires to stay away from it. For doing this, I only need to provide the battery positive and negative to the airbag connector and that's it. So, I stay away and provide the battery positive and negative right now. As you see, airbag is deployed and all this gas is being discharged. But what is it? Is it really toxic? Please remember that airbag deployment needs to be done very carefully and in an isolated area. So, please do not try it at home. At the end of this video, I have added the correct procedure to deploy the airbag, as my method is a bit different, just because I wanted to record this video. Let's have a look at inside the airbag. This is the airbag igniter. And here you see the gas generator. What is the main gas generator agent? It is sodium azide, that can create a massive amount of gas in a very short time. The gas produced after sodium azide explosion is toxic, so scientists were able to neutralize the sodium azide by adding the potassium nitrate and silicon dioxide. So we can say that the generated gas is less toxic now. But what gases will be generated after the airbag deployment? As a result of chemical reaction between those materials that I just told you, airbag will create a nitrogen gas very quickly. So, the majority of the gas is nitrogen, which is not harmful. But there is still a little bit sodium hydroxide, which can cause headaches, skin or eye irritation, dizziness, weakness or blurred vision. So considering the fact that created sodium hydroxide is very little, if you are not on the long exposure of this gas, there is a high chance that you will be okay. So, the best solution would be to get out of the vehicle as soon as possible after an airbag deploys to minimize effects of the exposure. Is this the end? No. As many companies are trying to enhance their standards, they already started using another gas generator called guanidine nitrate, which is less toxic and less explosive. Let's see the most correct procedure for the airbag deployment, which is safe and controlled.